All right, let's look at some Green Skins winning lists for March 2024. Thanks to my Kill Boss patron Panda, Wyberian Makes Good Art. Check out his link to Instagram below. And if you're going to buy dice, you might as well use Baron of Dice. Use code MDG to help support the channel. Boom. Okay, so this, let's look at this, some stuff here. So this is from the Adepticon AOS Champs 2024. This took place March 21st, and this was in Illinois in the United States. So let's see, what do we got here? There's a Bloodtooth list I wanted to take a look at, as well as a Gloomspites Gits list. Both of these players went 5-0, so let's have a look. So first we have Nicholas Walters playing Iron Jaws, Bloodtooth, Grand Strat Y inspired, all pretty standard stuff. Our leader, our heroes, Auric War Chanter with the Arcane Tome. That's interesting. This is Bloodtooth, right? Arcane Tome. So I guess we have Destroyer too. Interesting. So we have a War Chanter with Arcane Tome and Get 'em Beat. A Weird Knob Shaman with the Great Big Green Hand of Gork. A Mega Boss on Ma Crusha as the General with Hulking Brute. And Destroyer and Fasten. Pretty standard. And then another War Chanter with Fixin' Beat. And a Scragrot the Loon King. Okay. So, I mean, I've seen Scragrot the Loon King in Iron Jaws before. I mean, Iron Jaws have, like, they don't really have any good, like, ranged damage spells. So that's pretty cool. He also generates a command point, which is cool. A lot of his abilities are kind of wasted. I think, does he still get access to the whole Moon Clan lore if he's in? Like, if he's an ally? I kind of want to say that he doesn't, but on the other hand, I kind of want to say that he does. So, let's just see. It should be right here. Yeah, if part of a Gloomspite gets army. So he doesn't. So all he has is Fangs of the Bad Moon and Mystic Shield. But we have an Arcane Tome with War Chanter, so all we get really there is Mystic Shield. So let's keep going and see what we got. So we have a Reinforced Unit of Brutes, and then two Reinforced Units of Gorgruntas. This is generally what my lists look like. Andorian Acolytes, Warlord, Iron Jaws, Fist. So we're very high drop for a Iron Jaws list. 8 drops, because we're taking no battle reg. No battle reg. So we're very high drop. And then what? I guess we're taking the extra enhancement that we're taking as an Arcane Tome. So Arcane Tome, I mean, Andorian Acolytes. I guess he then fits in an Andorian Acolytes battalion. I mean, this list went 5-0. Right? So obviously this player is a good player. I'm just kind of... I would love to talk to this person. If you know this person from Illinois, Nicholas Walters, have him send me a message. I'd be curious to ask a couple questions. Because it's like, War Chanter is casting what? There's no endless spells, so Mystic Shield. Cool. Weird Numb Shaman, Great Big Green Hand of Gork. Cool. And Scragrot the Loon King, Fangs of the Bad Moon, and Arcane Bolts? Like, what are we taking here? Because there's a couple of other paths we could have taken. We could have just be lower drops instead of having an Arcane Tome. So, I'd be curious to know, like, how, like, what the plan was and how this went. We're getting more Primal Dice, right? So, that's fine, but I don't know. Interesting. It's like pretty similar to what I normally run and 30 points under, but it's not really like what I would run exactly. Like if I was going to run Scragrot, I'd still probably want to be 2 drops, right? 1 drop if possible. And I'm not sure if being low drops is better than an Arcane Tome or not. Because again, it depends on what the actual plan of the army is. So very curious, curious indeed. So here's from the same tournament, Michael Rausch's list from Gloomspite Gits. We're playing King's Gits with Chasing the Moon. Scragrot the Loon King is our... a Loon Boss is our general with Fight Another Day. Very interesting. This is the command tree that lets you retreat after you fight. So, sure. Madcap Shaman with Moonface Mammoth and Blizzard. That's fine. Lots of Bounders. Two reinforced unit of Bounders. Reinforced unit of Moonclan Stabas. Of course, that's with the that's to go with the Loon Boss, of course. Another reinforced unit of Stabas. So lots of just like frontline screens that can actually kind of hit. Two Sneaky Snufflers. So it looks like some of those guys are getting five up wards. Okay, and two drop. Okay, I see where this list is going. The Stabas are going to be, they're going to have five up wards. They're going to rally on four ups, and they're going to be able to actually kind of hit with the Loon Boss. Scragrot sitting behind them, and then Bounders to come in and actually slap. We're playing King's Gits, so we're going to get Gobblepalooza, Sneaky Snufflers. Pretty much everything in this list except for the leaders is going to come back. So that's cool. I like it. I see what's going on. So here we have another tournament. This is the Battle to End Alzheimer's 2024. And this took place in MD. I don't know what that is. In the United States. Let me just... MD State, US. What does it say? Maryland. Which is, of course, kind of like by... somewhere on the East Coast. Sorry. I'm a Canadian. Give me a break. And I'm happy to say that Jacob Brandon with Cruel Boys plays first. There's nothing really to go over with this list. If you're interested in this list, you should check out the interview that I did with Jacob Brandon. The video is called Jacob Brandon. This is the same list. And it is easily by far my favorite Cruel Boy list right now for sure. It's got 3x6 Bolt Boys, so it's got lots of Bolt Boys, and every single one has a Swamp Call of Shaman that hangs out with it. There's a Gobsprack, a Snatcher Boss, and then in the front we have two units of Gut Rippers, and then on the flanks we have one unit of Hobgrots and Dagok Stablads. Like, it's, to me, just a nice, clean list. It's got all the little bits and pieces that you need, and it's just really efficient. Dagok's Stablads make this list because it fits in at exactly 2,000 points. If this was 80 points, we wouldn't be able to fit it, and we would have 70 points to fill, and it would be awkward. So I'm really, really happy. Good job, Jacob. Keep showing up. Hey, Jacob, can you start losing with Cruel Boy so that we can get some buffs, please? Just kidding. Fourth edition is coming. So that's cool. Also, in the same tournament, we had a Grid and Blades list. Placed sixth. What is this person went 4-1. So that's phenomenal. So let's look at this list. So Grin and Blades with Crump them all, that's fine. Snatcher Boss is our general with Weirdin, Mork's Eye Pebble, and Super Sneaky. Cool. One Swamp Call of Shaman, two Swamp Call of Shamans, three Swamp Call of Shamans, and Gobsprack. 3x10 Gut Rippers, 3x6 Bolt Boys, and two drops battle regiment. So this is almost Jacob Brandon's list. The only difference here is that he's going for another 10 Gut Rippers as opposed to Dagox, Stablads, and Hobgrots. So he's got three bricks of 10 instead of two bricks of 10 and then two other sort of like smaller flanker units. So I prefer Jacob Brandon's list personally, but this is pretty much the same thing. 3x6 Bolt Boys, 3x Swamp Call of Shamans, right? Gobsprack, Sludge Raker. Very, very small difference here. Very small difference here. But I'm telling you, this is the way to play Cruel Boys right now. If you're looking for a Cruel Boys list and you want to win games and you want to ride out third edition, I would say this is the list that you want to go with for sure. But good job. Good job, boys. Good job, boys. Cool. Das Maul Wargaming Tournament 2024. This took place March 16th. And this was in England. So that's cool. And then there's a Glog's Mega Mob list that I wanted to look at here. So this is, of course, Gloomspike Gits, Glog's Mega Mob, Web Spinner Shaman on a Ragnarok Spider. And of course, this player was 4-1. This player went 4-1. So with a big Ragnarok Spider, that's cool. With a Dankhold Trog Boss, with Alpha Trog and Chloe Houset. So this is the one that makes him a monster, and this is the one that the artifact is the one that gives him the 4-up board. And then another Web Spinner Shaman with Merciless Blizzard. 2x6 Rock Guts and 2x3 Fellwaters. This is a nasty, nasty combo. The Rock Guts sit at the front in their line of six, and then the Fellwaters sit behind them, and then anything that comes charging into the Rock Guts gets Unleashed Held by the Fellwaters, and the Rockettes have pretty good rend. And so if you can't modify the saves at all from the Fellwaters, then the Rockettes are able just to use their rend just to crump whatever thing is standing in front of them. Really cool. And then we have some monsters. So we have some big Arachnorocs. We have the Spiderfang War Party times two. So that's pretty cool. So it's like lots of monsters, lots of rock guts. I mean, I've never seen a list like this before. Usually when I see, like, I've seen this 2x6 rock guts and 2x3 fell waters a bunch of times. And the Dankhold, right? And the web spinner with Merciless Blizzard, like all that's pretty standard. But usually what I see instead are like some screens. Like I see, you know, like Stabas, let's say. And then after that, I see things like Scragrod or Fungoid Cave Shamans or More Little Wizards, Gobblepalooza, Marsh Call of Slogoth. I see things like this. So it's kind of a different take. It's like rock, a bunch of Trogs, and then a bunch of big spiders, a bunch of big monsters. So I bet you that it's a lot faster. I bet you it takes up more of the board. It has weaker casting, probably does less damage. But I mean, awesome. And then we have a Geminids. That's cool. I like it. Are we one drop? No, we're not one drop. We're more than that. We're at least two, three, four drops, looks like. But I don't know, that's cool. This is the kind of list that I would definitely put on the table just to have a fun game with. That's for sure. So that's awesome. And again, if this player, if you guys know this person, Jack Morton, if you know this guy, send him my way. I'd love just to have a little chat and see how that list played and see what the thought process is behind it. Okay, was there a list here that I wanted to check out? No? Then why are we even here? Oh yeah, I want to check out this Gloom Spike Gets list. So let's see. This list didn't do, you know, we're one, two, this list went four and one. Oh yeah, and there's a three and two Great End Blades list. We can look at this one too. Well, let's start with the, so this is Chris Lamois, very French name, I'm hoping. So we're playing King Skits with Protect the Shrine, Madcap Shaman is our general with the Clammy Hand, and Moonface Mammoth for Artifact of Power. So because we have the Clammy Hand and we have King Skits, we're going to be bringing back our units more reliably and consistently, so that's cool. And the only other hero that we have is Scragrod the Loon King. So a Madcap Shaman that's going to hide behind the Shrine and then Scragrod. One unit of Stabas, two units of Stabas, a reinforced unit of Bounders, and a double reinforced unit of Bounders, and then a reinforced unit of Fanatics, and another unit of Fanatics. Phenomenal. Gobblepalooza and Sneaky Snufflers. Like, that's pretty cool. I like this list too. I really like Fanatics. I think Fanatics are underrated, and I'm really happy to see some good use of Fanatics here. The Snufflers, I guess, could be really good on throwing him on the Bounders, right? Or even on the Stabas. Like, when you have a 4-up rally, you know, if you have a 5-up ward and you lose a bunch of your models, like, you could just rally up to 10 of them back, right? Like, you can get half the unit back. So with that 5-up ward will actually protect them from, you know, not dying completely. But that's pretty cool. Yeah, I like this list. That's a cool list. Again, slightly different from what I take, you know, normally, but seems pretty good. And then from the same tournament, we have Chris Hall, who is playing Cruel Boys with Grin and Blades. We have one Swamp Call of Shaman, two Swamp Call of Shaman, three Swamp Call of Shaman, Gobsprack, and Snatcher Boss with Mork's Eye Pebble, Super Sneaky, and Fasten. Pretty standard. Is this Jacob Brandon's list? 2x10 Gut Rippers and a unit of Hobgrots. This is Jacob Brandon's list. Right, here we go. So it's like, of all these lists from March, three Cruel Boy lists did well. And they're all basically the same list. It's the way to play Cruel Boys right now. Maybe I should make a video how to win with Cruel Boys, and it's just like, oh, just play this list. Just play this list. That's how you do it. Easy game. Cool. So that's fun. Okay, last one we got here is Rumble in the Rockies. This is an AOS GT. This took place in Calgary, Alberta. So this is something that I would love to go to these. These are the kind of, just to give you a sense of how, okay, I'm not gonna show you where I live in my video, but if I wanted to go to Rumble in the Rockies, so this is gonna be one of the closest tournaments to where I live, except for in my actual hometown. So if I wanted to get there, I don't know how you guys feel, but I probably wouldn't wanna drive, or sorry, wouldn't wanna take a plane. because I'd be afraid of putting my army down in the cargo or whatever. But for me to get to this tournament, which again is like one of the closest GTs that I could go to, it's 8.5 hour drive. And I have to drive over, I have to literally drive through the Rocky Mountains. I'm gonna start on one side of the Rocky Mountains, and I'm gonna have to drive 8.5 hours through the Rocky Mountains. So it's not really like I could wake up in the morning and, like, you know, get there by the time the GT started. Because if it was only an hour away and it started at 8:30, let's say, or 8 o'clock, like, it's okay, I'm gonna get up at 6 and shower and have some coffee, and I'm gonna drive out. But can't do 8.5 hours in the morning before I go. So this is like, I would need like 4 days to go to a 2-day tournament. So it's like, you gotta fly, like, it's, you know, flying on Friday night, flying on Sunday night. Man, I need a lot more patrons so I can pay for plane tickets. And I mean a lot more patrons, like hundreds and hundreds of patrons. Pretty much gotta pay a Sherpa to carry my models across the Rocky Mountains. Right, placings. Cool. So we have a Cruel Boys list here, a Big Yellers list that I want to check out. And I think that was it. That was all that I really saw here. Yep. Oh, there's a Stomper Tribe list. Okay, so we're playing Big Yellers. So this right away is not Jacob Brandman's list, but we'll see how... Oh, yeah, it's looking different already. So we have Gobsbrack. Sludge Raker Beast is our general with Super Sneaky and Fasten. Pretty standard. We have another Snatcher Boss with more Psy Pebbles. So we're playing two Snatcher Bosses on Sludge Raker Beasts here. And I guess that they're both taking enhancements, right? One has Fasten, Super Sneaky, and the other one has more Psy Pebble. So I'm kind of curious here, because like my first thought is like, well, if you're going to play two Sludge Rakers, one of them is going to be more aggressive with Fasten, and the other one's going to be more defensive with Super Sneaky and more Psy Pebble, right? If you were like, I want to put enhancements on both, that's kind of how I would see it. But that I wouldn't want to put Fasten on the general. But I guess our grand strategy is Wah. So we can use Fasten to get our grand strat. So again, would love to talk to this player, Mitch Bradshaw, if you're out there. Murknob on Belchabana. So I'm wondering if this is something that we're expecting in the meta. Or maybe the Fasten is to help get the... to help catch up to a Super Sneaky block of 30 Gut Rippers. Double reinforced, right? Okay, and then we have a double reinforced unit of Gut Rippers, a double reinforced unit of Bull Boys, and then a unit of Hobgrass Slitters to fill the battle line. So this, to me, is a very different Cruel Boys list. So I'm kind of eating my own words now that the only way to play is to play Jacob Brandon's list, right? But and then we're 5 drops. So interesting. Interesting. Would love to talk to this player about how their games went and how and like what the strategy was here, because this is quite different. This is quite different. To me, this looks way more aggressive. So, I mean, it's only 2 Swamp Call of Shamans. I'm guessing one goes with the Gut Rippers and one goes with the Bull Boys. So, interesting. It's kind of like all in, right? Like if you start losing Bull Boys, you know, you're going to have a bad time. Because you're running a lot fewer, you're running half as many Bolt Boys as Jacob Brandon's list, right? So, yeah, would love to let this player know, let this player know I'm looking to chat. But until then, hopefully, I mean, so like in recap, what did we really see? Didn't see any big Wah, right? One Iron Jaws listed did good, but the rest of them are Cruel Boys. Like, it's so funky. It's so funky, and I don't even know what to say about it. It's like, how come here we are again? Like, you can check out my video, what's going on with Cruel Boys, but the pattern continues. Cruel Boys are at the bottom of the meta, but winning tournaments. What? Please help me make sense of this. Like, subscribe. Wah.